Well, I just have to tell you that, Jim, we've been looking all over for you. Headline news breaking all around us. I've declared martial law, dismissed the Congress. And here I find you fraternizing. I understand that this is something in the nature of, well, shall we say, a roast. And I don't know whether Jim is prepared for that yet or not. Here you are. And therefore, I would like to ask all of you, you know, there's still a long way to go on the honeymoon, and Nancy says he's Y and H. So, even though it's a roast, that means young and handsome. So, please be gentle. And, Jim, you're not to take seriously anything they say. As a matter of fact, don't take anything seriously that I've said so far. But I will be serious for a minute. I think that this is born out of a respect and affection that is widespread among these people and which you have earned. And let's cancel the lottery. Or were you going to promise that later?
I didn't want to make any unilateral concessions. Now you've given it away.
Well, that's one of the major decisions we've made. We got some minor things going on, like El Salvador and Afghanistan and so forth. But you can see that when it comes to the big decisions, we make them fast and hard. Well, anyway, I'm glad that we could drop by here, and I'm glad that you're all doing this.
Thank you, Mr. President.
And I'm very glad that Jim is where he is, and I mean that seriously, in our administration. Yeah. Enjoy. We're on our way to Ford Theater.